Well, as you can see, we have some of the one of the Star Destroyers here, and here's another one of the vessels for Armada. As you see, they're really painted really, really well. I really like those. And I'm really, really excited to do a couple things with them. As you can see. And I'm looking forward to getting this game back on the table. So I guess a bunch of stuff is supposed to come out next week. So I figured I'd get them all ready. And see. Hey, Darth, what are you doing here?
Aren't my ships beautiful?
They sure are. I really think there's something special. What do you got in mind here, Darth?
Aren't these ships just beautiful?
Well, they sure are, Darth. And thanks for getting in the camera way. I mean, what are you even doing here?
I'm inspecting the ships. Leave me alone or I will choke you with my mind.
Oh, don't let me get in the way there, big fella.
Ah, these are just perfect. Where are my fighters?
Let me pull them up. Whoops.
What?
Yeah, they're pretty lousy, aren't they?
These are unacceptable.
I agree. What do you think, how about we throw a cone of, you know, some paint on these and see if we can get them to match up? I mean, it's kind of a shame that those other ships are looking really, really nice and these are just kind of gray plastic for everything. I mean, we've got some detail, we can work with it. What do you think, Darth? We'll give it a shot?
You had better do well, or you will deal with the dark side of the Force.
Well, you put it that way. Let's get to work. Wow. Seems like I can't escape this guy lately. Every time I do something Star Wars, Darth Vader's there. But anyways, I figured we'd take a look and I'd show you guys how to quickly paint these guys up and get them so they kind of match everything. I mean, you have beautiful big ships and then blah. But let's see what we can do with them. See if we can snazz them up a little bit. Let's take a look at the table. Now, first off, let's take a look at the work area. We've got a couple of the models and I keep them over here. And for the most part, if you got a whole bunch of stuff, you want to kind of pretty much just machine through it, or as they do, line it up and just knock them out one at a time. I usually keep an assortment of brushes. I'll pick out a bunch and keep them over there on my nice white tile. I have a piece of tile. It's actually, it holds the water very, very well. It's very good for thinning out paint. You have to thin your paints out. All right, either that or it's going to clog things up and then you're just going to have a mess. And that's the last thing that you want. You don't want to lose any detail that you have. And some of these production values, I mean, they're nice, but they don't hold, you know, some of them are not extremely detailed. So you want to keep whatever detail you can. I usually keep a palette that I'll usually just mix my, I can mix certain colors if I want to. If I want a darker gray or a lighter gray, I'll keep a palette out. I have a smaller one. I sometimes keep a little medium in here just to thin things out and keep everything nice and smooth. Like I said, you don't want to dry out your paint. I also, because I'm old and blind, I have a magnifying glass, which is like key for me because I can't see worth a darn. So sometimes it's just good. And let's see if this will actually work. Oh, there you go. You know, you can actually see real close up. And for me, that's perfect for what I'm trying to accomplish here.
You know, sometimes you want to get detail lines, and these things are pretty small, so you do want to get as close as you can. You don't have to get really close with these, but you know, we're going to try to do it, and I'm going to try to show you a way that it's fun, it's easy, and it adds to your game. So let's get ready and let's get to it. So here we go. So as you can see, I'm going to give you both colors that I've used. I'm using slate gray for the Americana, okay, because I'm going to paint them both ways, and I'm using a Dawnstone and the Citadel line. Always shake your paint. Here, let me back out a little bit here. There we go. Always shake your paint, take a little out, and close the lid. That is key, or else your paints will dry out, and then a nice $5 little pot like this will be worth less than nothing. And with these, you know, they're lesser paints, but you can get away with a lot more. Now, always have some kind of reference material. So I'm looking kind of right here, and I decided to pull out my X-Wing stuff and say, okay, what do I want to do here? Well, I can see that, like on these guys, you do have some detail there that you can pull out. So I'm going to base them white. I'm going to base these guys gray with the Dawnstone. And then we're going to do our, like here, we're going to take care of that. We're going to do a wash over it. Yes, you should use washes. They really help, and they really bring out the weather effect. And I think you'll see what I'm talking about. So, right now, while I'm talking, I'm not painting. So, I'm going to take a little Dawnstone out. And I'm just going to get enough that I need. I'm going to push it onto my palette, wet it down, and listen. If it's too watered down, that isn't a bad thing either, because it'll just go on thinner. Sometimes it's better to just do two coats. And I always like to do two coats because it just doesn't come through all the time. So let's see here how much I can zoom in here. And I will try to keep everything within perspective here. And you can see I'm just taking, I like a thicker brush. Not so much a thicker, but a stiffer brush. Particularly because of my eyes, I feel I have more control with it. It depends what you're gonna like, and that's what you need to go with. And you can see here that I am just going over these. Oops, bring it back into the camera here. And take a little more. I always take a little more water, work it in. And I really didn't take that much. But, you know, especially with this already being gray, I just want to get a good prime coat over this. So when we do the wash, it'll really come out nice. And make these look good for you guys. Let's grab another unit here. And again, grab some of that paint. It's an older brush because I'm just trying to throw this on here more or less like a primer. You know, to take these off and spray them would be more of a hassle, and it's almost better to do this and just go with a nice base coat over it. And just to get that plastic look out and get some paint on this. So hopefully I'm staying in camera. And you guys are seeing exactly what I'm doing. You see how, with a nice thin coat, I still have those lines of definition there. And that's what we really need, is to keep those lines of definition. So I'm going to cut this off, let this dry. And then let's go over to the X-Wings. Let's not let Darth know that, okay? Because you know how upset he gets over anything that has to do with the rebels. So let's try to keep them out of here. Okay, now we're using a skull light. And I'm watering it down. I'm sure you don't want to see me do that. But I am painting these guys a very thin coat. Thin, folks. Don't worry what it looks like, because you have to have vision here. And that's what I'm going to help you with. I'm going to help you develop your vision so you see and you start to understand. When you look at a picture, you'll start thinking of how you can break it down. And that's the thing. You know, somebody can sit here, well, we're going to use soggy bone and we're going to use this and you need to water down your paints. Well, that's not going to do you good unless you start having some sort of vision of what you want to see. And by having it in front of you, like this particular thing, you have to be able to break. Oops, I'm sorry. Let me get these out of the way, because I started on a rant and now I can't. Now you're looking at that and you're saying, okay, well, I don't see. How do I achieve that? Well, I'm going to show you how to achieve that, how to get this, even on something this small. And just having the vision, looking at the little details. Well, how do you get the shading? How do you get that 3D effect? Well, I'm going to show you guys. That's for doggone sure. And like I said, anybody can do this. Anybody. With a little, you know, just a little patience. And that's why when I show you things, I'm going to show you two different colors, because what I really want to do is I don't want you to go run out and spend a ton of money on paints, okay? I don't want you to go, especially if you're a beginner, to go out and buy $200 worth of paints and then find out this is something that you don't like to do, or you find frustrating, or you're making a ton of mistakes with very expensive paints. That's why when I tell you what we're doing, I cross-reference, I give you the Citadel and I give you the Americana. And that way, you know, depending on how brave you want to be, and remember, the brave may not live forever, but the cautious never truly live. See, that's a little old man wisdom. But depending on how you want to do it, you know, you have a choice. And I don't think a lot of websites give you a lot of choices. They show you their style and that's it. And I want to adapt where what I want to do with a lot of these painting things is make it so it's easy and we can talk about it. We can discuss it. If you're having problems, I'll sit here and I don't care if I have to paint till the cows come home. When do the cows come home? Does anybody have an answer to that? But, you know, the thing is I will do whatever it takes to make sure that I show you and help you through everything. If I don't know it, and believe me, are there better painters than me? Of course, there's always somebody better out in the world, okay? And I don't think I'm that good. I think I'm just, you know, an average painter at best. As you can see, I'm just getting in the details here. The paint is nice and thin. We're not losing anything here. We're keeping whatever detail these little fighters have on the little fighters. Okay. Just a little bit back here. And there we go. All right. But my point is that what I want to do is help you develop into, you know, you've got to be happy with your work. And that's the only person that matters. It doesn't matter what anybody else thinks. It's what you think. Have you developed your talent enough to where you're happy with what you're doing? And that's what it really comes down to. So we're going to cut off here and we're going to let these dry, and then we're going to come back and we're going to start with the TIE Fighters. Okay, so now you see that I am working on the TIE Fighters and I am painting these squares. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to do this. First of all, keep your brush nice and wet. Keep your paint wet. I can't stress that enough. You can put paint on your paintbrush and it's dry paint. And then you're working with something that you can't move around because it's drying too quickly. That's why you'll always hear people say, thin your paints, because they're easy to work with. Now, the key here, and forgive me, I'm going to move this a little bit so I can put my hand under here. Make sure that you are sitting square. That's number one. Number two, always, and I mean always, with something like this, you want to start in the middle. See how I'm starting in the middle there? And I'm going, but I'm working my way out to the line that I want to work to. Okay? And keeping good, full strokes. Not dabbing, but strokes. You see that? So let's do it again. Whoops. See, I got this eyeglass thing here, which isn't helping things, folks. So just bear with me. Because I really want you to see things. I don't want you to look at things from a distance. So again, all right, the middle, okay? You feel the flow, control the paint, control your brush, and then work it out. See how I'm working it out to that line there? And I'm just dragging it. There we go, see? Getting it? Let's do it again. Gonna bore you guys to death because I'm gonna do the same thing over and over and over again in the middle. Move it, slide it. See how thin my paint is? I'm gonna have to go over this with another coat. That's fine, but it's easier now because you could just fill in the gaps. Let's do it again. Let's just do the whole panel. How's that, guys? And make sure that, you know, you can either glue this to a top of something. Well, not glue it because it's the base. You can put it on something, put it on a cork, whatever works for you. For me, just having both of my elbows on the table and being able to control things with both hands, because I'm very, very shaky. I'm hoping you guys aren't seeing that. Hold on. There you go. I'm sorry. In the middle. Okay, I'm just making sure that it's on the camera. In the middle, and work your way out to the line. And if you make a mistake, who cares? Just take a little gray. Fix it. You're gonna make mistakes. Doesn't mean the model's ruined. Just means you gotta paint a little more. Alright, let's see here. I also have my glasses on, so I'm trying to look at the camera line. Okay, there we go. Alright, and then we're just going to paint out like that. See how I'm just staying very consistent, starting in the middle. See, I still got a little paint here. I'm starting and I'm just dragging everything out. Nice and easy, nice and calm. Look at that. There we go. I know what you're saying. Oh, wow, look at the middle of those. And look at the edges. Don't worry, we're going to clean that up. And I'm going to show you how we're going to clean that up. Because the edges are all gray. Now, the two colors that I used for that are... it is a lamp and chaos black. So it's lamp in the Americana and chaos black for the Citadel line, just so you guys know. So let's get these guys out of here, and I'll be back when I'm done with everybody, with all the TIE fighters, and I'll show you what we're gonna do next. Okay, as you can see, we got the paint on these guys and the paint on these guys. So now here's probably the most important part that you are going to do for this whole thing. All right, and that's a wash. I hope these come out good, because I really don't want Darth Vader coming out and giving me a hard time about it. That guy's really a pain in the neck. So, first of all, let me pop Darth off here. We're going to use noon oil. There's no other way around it. This is a $5, $4 shade. You can get it from Citadel. I believe that Valero has some. I don't use theirs. I like this stuff. I think this stuff is the best. And this is what I use all the time. So you shake it up good. And you start to apply it. Let me get a brush here that would be appropriate for such. Because what you want to do here, and bear with me. There we go. Come on. Open up. Sometimes these things just don't want to stay where you want them to. I like to get some on my brush and then take the target. Okay, let's get it in camera view. And actually, I'm going to move this up. And you see what I'm doing here? See how I'm moving it around? All right. We're going to take, and we're going to go over that. You see how all of a sudden that white goes from just being a white to now all of a sudden it's got some depth in there. And you start to see the detail. This is what I was talking about when we put on the hold on. Let me get a little more here. This is what I was talking about when we put on the primer coat. How you water down your paints so you do not lose the detail. You see the detail there? If you put too much paint on there, this wash wouldn't be worth a hill of beans. Did I just say hill of beans? Now look at that. Just like that, we've just brought these things to life. And people that don't use this or say, oh, well, you know, I'm not trying to win this, that, and the other. Well, guess what? This stuff is almost like liquid talent. Oh, let me put, there we go. Get a little more light on it. There we go. You see what we just did? We went from this, just plain old white, to all of a sudden now we have detail, we have depth, we have character. You know, it looks like it's been through something. And we're not even done yet, folks. Look how easy that was. See? Anybody can do this. Anybody. Even me. So now let's grab these guys. Oops. Sorry, I almost took that out of range there. And again, I'm using an old brush. Brush I'm not too worried about. And boom. Now all of a sudden that's getting in the recesses. And that's what you want to do. You don't want it to pool up. You don't want to get so much in there that it pools up in one area. But you want to get it into the recesses. See how it gets in that recess? Let me show you. See this area in between here? In between. You don't want it to sit high. You want, see how it's pulling up there a little bit? And I'm just taking my brush and I'm moving it around. Look at that. Boom. All of a sudden, we're in business here. We're taking our brushes, we're taking our wash, and we are just taking and moving and filling in the blanks there, because there is detail there. And We want to get behind here. See what I'm doing here? How also now all the engines come alive and the back of it comes alive. And all I'm doing is just taking this wash and moving it around. Moving it around nice and easy. And you'll get a feel for it. You'll see it as it pulls up. Just take it and move it around. There we go. All right, I'll be back after I wash the rest of this stuff. Okay, and now we're going to take our wash and we're going to do the same thing for our TIE fighters. I'll get back in camera view. Hold on. Okay, and what we're going to do is we're going to smather that on there. And now, do you see what I was talking about? How all of a sudden this now kind of straightens everything out. Look how those lines are now. Everything just comes together all of a sudden. That's why when it doesn't look like anything right away, don't worry about it. You still got a ways to go. You can always fix everything. Everything can be fixed as long as you have a paintbrush. Oops, let's get that out of there. Sorry, I'm trying to keep this in camera so you guys can see. So I hope, first of all, I hope you're enjoying this. And then we're going to smather this in here. And those little duck holes, there was no way you're going to get your paintbrush in there. But you can get the wash into there. Into these, see now all of a sudden that blackens that up. You see what I'm talking about? See how that all of a sudden that comes alive and has depth. And I get back there and there and there and there. All of a sudden it's all come alive. Now we're gonna let that dry. I missed a spot here. That's okay, I'm allowed. And you can see I did these already. I went over them. Cool. So, oops, sorry. Let me pull this up a little. Oh, maybe down a little bit. There we go. Boy, I'm doing a great job taping this, huh? So there we go. We're gonna pull this back a little bit. I think that's the best way to do it, and then at the end we'll show you how it all comes together. All right, so we're gonna let that dry and then we'll move on to the next stage. Okay, the next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna paint the engines, and all we're gonna do is just take either lead belcher in Citadel or what do they call it in America? No, it's actually folk art, which is the cheap stuff. Yeah, right, none of it's ever cheap, but the folk art is, it's called gunmetal, and you can get that. And what we want to do is just kind of get around and get these all kind of looking like they do in the movie. So you just take your very thin brush and just take your time. Go over them. Doesn't have to be perfect. There we go. And that'll be that. And I don't think we need any gunmetal there, so that's good. So that's all there was. That it was just a very simple thing, so you can actually just use it right out of the pot. It's okay if it's a little thick. So we're gonna wash off our brush. Always clean your brushes in between uses, you know, just really make sure you clean them good. The most important thing is never to let the paint get into this area, because then the brush does this. If you have a point like this, it'll do that. And you don't want to do that, because when paint dries in there, it spreads those hairs out. You want to keep everything tight so you have the utmost control. The next color is Mephiston Red, or True Red. And what you're going to do, now this is hard, okay? And even I'm going to have a bit of a trouble with this. I'm just going to take a little dab of this, just a little. I'm going to bring it over to my palette and I'm going to water it down. And this is where we're going to get that line here. Now this is tough to do, but I've noticed on every model that there's a mold line. So all you're going to want to do, I've already done these, but I wanted to show it to you because I got ahead of myself and I didn't realize the camera wasn't running. So I was talking to nobody. Is you just kind of want to very easily go along the line there. And that's all we want to do. So we have that look. Now I messed up here, but that's okay. I'm going to fix that in a minute, because we're just going to take and we're going to bring a little white over that and we're going to bring it back to life there. So that's how you do that. You don't have to put those red lines on there if you feel they're too tough to do. It's not a necessity. It's not going to change how things are. Well, these are drying. The next thing that we're going to want to do is we're going to want to take our black again. So let me just get a little bit of black out there. And we're only going to need a smidgen of this. I mean, barely enough to make a difference in anything. And I'm just going to take and water this down a little bit. And what we want to kind of do here, okay, bear with me, is the cockpits there. Right in the front here. I'm going to try to, I don't know how much I can do, go in here. But you want to stay, and all you want to do is just dab that in there. There we go. Dab that in there. And you can see my hands aren't exactly the... I'm not the best here as far as keeping my hands steady. I'm old. I'm an old man. All right, let's see here. Let's get these guys up here. Let's see if that's in camera range. Great. Fantastic. And we're going to put our little black dot there. And just take your time. See, I'm even talking to you and I'm able to do it. Just nice and easy. Move the brush around a little bit and it gives it that depth. Perfect. All right, we're on our way here. Now next, we're going to take from Americana, it's called Island Blue. And it's a very, very light blue. And the reason being is that there we go. Yeah, well, I should have shook that a little bit better. I didn't. Bear with me, folks. See, even I make mistakes. What am I talking about? I'm a walking mistake. All right. So we're going to take this Island Blue. I'm going to move some over here. See, I don't worry about it when it comes out of that Americana stuff. I'll just take and mix that around a little bit, move it over here. And right behind here is, I'm sorry I moved the camera, but I am going to make it look like these engines are firing off. And I'm going to do the same thing for the TIE fighter. So we're going to just stick a little in there, stick a little in there. I think you'll see what I'm getting at. You see, because I got this so nice and wet, it's just going in there perfectly. So let's grab a little more of it. There we go. And in there. Oh, I hope you're in camera, because right now I'm trying to use the... Yes, you guys are in camera, so let's see if I can, how close I can get. Yeah, see what I'm doing there? See how I'm filling up over the gunmetal and making it look like they're actually the engines are firing off. Gives it a little more color, gives it a little more pizzazz. There. Oh, that's my fault for making that go out. See what we got there? What do you guys think so far? You know, I think it's very important that you guys leave comments. It means a lot to me, number one. Number two, now they had some of this. Well, I think we're going to do it that way. Yeah, I don't think we're going to go over the top of the thing because we'll be here all day. Okay, so let me zoom back out here a bit. It's important that you guys leave your comments. Number one, it means a lot when I hear from you guys. Number two, have questions for me. Because the next time I paint or something, or if you have a painting question or something, I'll answer it. But what I'm going to try to do is each thing that I try to paint, or if we have a series of something, where I'm going to come on and continue painting something, like on Painting 101. I'm going to take your questions, and I'm going to call out your name, and I'm going to say, hey, Joe or Ed or Jeff asked, you know, how do you do this? How do you do that? So there, we got the retros there. And let's do the same thing for these guys here. Actually, these guys don't have it. Oh, yeah, they do. There we go. I'm sorry. Boy, I'm losing my mind. It's been one heck of a week, I'll tell you that much. The way I got jobbed and everything else. Oh, well. That's life, folks. There you go. See? Gives a little color. Gives a little pop there. And then, of course, bear with me, because we're going to do these guys, too. So let's get them all in position so we can do them. You get, you know, I don't know if you like what I'm doing. If you don't, you know, this is just my take on it. Maybe somebody else has a better take. Who knows? Who knows? I don't worry about it. Boom. There we go. See? I like getting that hole filled up, so when it dries it, I mean, it really has a nice effect. Boom. And there you go. Now everybody looks like they're going someplace. And they have a purpose. Let's clean off our brush. But the thing I was trying to say is that, I want to answer your questions. I want, you know, there may be things that I can't answer that I'll go find the answer for at least. And, like I said, this is your channel. I really believe that, you know. I'm here to do my charities, paint, enjoy things, do the best I can with a lot of things here, and really just make things as nice as possible as I can for you guys. So, you know, you have a place to go that, you know, when life gets a little too stressful, guess what? You come over here. All right, we've got one more thing to do, and then we're going to be done with these, and I'll show them off. So, bear with me. Okay, last thing we got to do for the TIE Fighters is dry brush. Now, what's dry brushing? For some of you that may want to know, you're going to take your paint, like so. I'm taking the slate gray that we originally took them with, and then I am taking a brush and I am cleaning the brush off. Now this is a proper dry brush. Now I've seen people dry brush where they just have a lot of paint on there and say, well, this is dry brushing and this is the way I do it. But the way you dry brush here is there's hardly anything on there. You really gotta brush this paint on here to get anything, because all you want to do is just highlight the tops. You want to get the raised parts. You don't want to take away the black that you did. You want to just kind of go over things and take a couple of brush strokes to really go over things and barely get any paint off that brush. But all it'll do is go over the higher points. Now let's take a look at that. Let's see if we can zoom in on that. Now look what happened there when I did that. Okay. You see how the wash stayed in the windows, okay? But when I dry brushed over it, I started to get that form back over the raised areas. And that's what you want. You don't want where it fills the areas. You want where it barely even touches it. Well, that's great for camera. No, I won't edit that out. And you can see now. Now all of a sudden we have depth. Now these things look like they belong out in space. Right, Darth?
Yeah, right.
Let's back out. Sorry, guys. Bear with me. Just taking and going. Remember when I told you that, okay, yeah, we got some black there. That's okay, because I'm going to go over. See how I'm just hitting that edge there, but I'm not taking anything off of here. And again, right into the windows, right where we want it. We didn't lose anything on the sides. Perfect. All right, let's clean our brush and do the other guys. Okay, now we just do the same thing with the white, and we're just kind of very easily going over, so we're not losing any of that detail. Oh, I'm sorry, I went off camera. Just going underneath, just keeping those edges nice, and you can see we've got ourselves a nice little squadron there. And we do the same thing for our guys right here. So, with that said, that is going to conclude. I'm going to do the rest of these. And I think I got a whole bunch of them. And then I think we're going to do a little bit of a playthrough at some point. But there you go. That's how you take care of the fighters. Oh, excuse me. I don't know what Darth would think, but I hope he's not around, and I definitely don't want to find out. But that's the way you do it. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope it was fun for you. I hope it was informative. It's nothing perfect, but it sure beats just having this. When you can have this. Whoops. So, I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. And I hope you play more Armada. I know there's a bunch of Wave 2 is coming out. Is it Wave 2 or Wave 3? Is coming out. And I believe that they're coming out with all kinds of different smaller ships. So maybe we'll do those too in a future episode. With that said, this is Rob. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing, and we'll see you soon.